Hi, I'm Anne McEntee, and I'm in Renewable Energy Services, and I'm here today with Erik Schiemann, our Solar General Manager in GE Current. So thanks for joining us, Erik.
Thank you.
And one of the things that we really want to talk about is how to manage failure in your career. And first of all, I think it's really important that we reframe the term failure, because failure, and at least in my mind, is not really a failure. It's an unsuccessful attempt. If you stick with it, you persevere, as Erik has done in shaping our solar business for CNI, I just view it as, hey, you're going to have unsuccessful attempts along the way, and at some point, something is going to click. And so, Erik, with that, let's first talk about, just give us a baseline. What is your solar business, and what was it like 3 years ago?
Yeah, so, you know, three, four years ago, we were a concept. And so we had to take a kind of a leap and say, well, how do we go test this out?
So you know, it's funny, when Erik and I were working 3 years ago together, we had taken all these shots on, hey, do we manufacture panels? What do we do with technology? Because the industry was taking off. Panel prices really had collapsed, right, three years ago.
Yeah.
And so Erik came to me as a leader and said, look, I've got this idea about changing our business model. And you really ran with it. So I just applaud you. So how do you think about courage? And how did you instill courage in your team to take the risk and try something different after we had to pivot?
We needed a group that were almost like the Expendables that could just be like, hey, let's get out there and let's actually do this. Let's go try this. And how do we instill courage in that? Just saying, you know what? The crazy thing is while we all respect where GE is at, the reason we're here is because we just don't know. And you could be the person that helps us get to, hey, I know now.
Absolutely.
And so in that small group, we just said, hey, let's figure this out.
You know, and if you think about it, the industry was just moving so fast
right.
at the time. If you weren't in it, you were clearly going to lose.
Yes.
So you needed to be in it to learn and to test and to see what worked.
Right.
So explain to me the leadership support that you needed. And you know, you and I had many meetings early on, but what made the difference for you?
Well, I think your approach helped a lot. And I'd say your approach, if I had to sum it up, was let's pulse where you're at. Tell me what you think you need. And then what's the next point that you and I need to discuss or need to talk about, but run until then. But I trust that you're also going to run fast and deliver a result that then we can take the next step off of. And I think that was really key.
Now, I'm sure you didn't do everything perfectly. What were some of the little failures that you had that you turned into unsuccessful attempts because you persevered through them?
I think we definitely, over the first year, pitched too many times the wrong value proposition and really made, I mean, I actually was thrown out of a large opportunity in Boston where I cold called myself. Like, I just showed up. I thought the GE brand would get me the meeting. And they actually like said, you have to leave the premises. And so we had to learn how to, you know, actually go in and target both the customer, but then also target our approach. And that was a huge amount of failure. Like, you know, just really, you had to put the ego aside and say, I'm going to get whacked today.
You know, and it's funny because, you know, as we would have reviews, sometimes it's okay not to tell your leaders those type of things and learn. Sometimes it's better not to wave your arms and say, look what I'm doing, but actually do it, have the trust between the leader and the business, you know, the business owner, and let you guys run with things. How should they go for it as you think about it? So I'm a, you know, I'm somebody who has a great idea. My manager's not quite ready to give me support. What advice would you have for them?
Create a solution where the manager can't say no. And just like, hey, if I had this, I could do this. And then if I can do this, I'll know this. And that's how sequentially I'll figure this out. I think those asks are the easy ones that you get a yes to. And you can prove your model or prove your idea in faster fashion.
And so you're almost saying beg, borrow, and steal.
Definitely.
Get people excited about your idea. Mm-hmm. Go test it out.
Right.
And then once you've proven it with enough depth, then's the time to kind of ask for a little bit more investment dollars or one or two additional resources to get aligned. So look, Erik, I think you've done a great job taking the risk, and your learnings of, you know, stick with it, test out your theories, don't ask for the big investment right up front, but really prove out your concept and build confidence in your leaders so that they'll want to fund you because it'll be so obvious. Those are just great learnings. And the fact that there really isn't anything such as a failure, because it's really just an unsuccessful attempt, because you persevere through the learnings and you reapply those learnings to get to something that's successful, like your solar business in Current. So congratulations, and really appreciate you spending time with us today.
No, thank you, and thank you to Anne for believing in us so many years ago, and it's fun to be here, so thanks a lot. I appreciate it.